We've just replaced the connecting rods in the FA20 engine fitted to our Toyota 86 development vehicle. And when it comes to the initial startup, this is where we do need to apply a little bit of care. Now, in most instances, with a fresh engine build, we would need to go through the process of bedding in or breaking in that new engine. In our case, though, you'll recall that we haven't replaced the piston rings and we also haven't had the engine block honed. So there's technically no break-in process required here. All we've done is we've replaced our connecting rods and our big end bearings. We will still be starting the engine up here with a slightly cheaper mineral-based engine oil, and we're going to be running the engine up to full operating temperature before dumping that oil. And this just allows us to flush out any of the assembly lubricant that we've used during the assembly process. We'll then be refilling the engine with a normal Motul full synthetic 300V oil that we run in the car, and we'll be ready to hit the dyno. Now, if you had in fact replaced the rings, then yes, a break-in process is necessary. And this is one of the areas where I see a huge amount of misinformation and confusion out there in the industry, mainly around what we're actually trying to do during the break-in process. There's all sorts of concepts around breaking in or bedding in the bearings against the crankshaft, heat cycling the engine, and really all of this is complete nonsense. Let's deal with the bearings for a start. Now, the bearings do not run against the crankshaft. They must be protected by a film of engine oil. And any time we've got metal-to-metal contact between the bearing shell and the crankshaft journal, we're going to end up with instantaneous damage, and no amount of gentle driving is going to help you in that case. So we're not doing anything in terms of bedding in the bearings. Let's move on to the heat cycling process. Now, I think there's some confusion here between the term heat cycling and heat treatment. And again, this is absolute nonsense. The sorts of temperatures that we're likely to see in our engine when it's actually running are nowhere near the sort of temperatures that are genuinely used for the heat treatment of our engine components. So again, not something that we need to worry about. Really, when it comes down to it, the key aspect of bedding in or breaking in a freshly built engine is really all about the interface between the piston rings and the cylinder wall. What we're trying to do is get the rings to seal against the cylinder wall, and we've got that nice fresh hone pattern on the bores that helps with that process. And this is really critical because if we get our piston rings sealing well against the bores, we're going to end up with an engine that produces good power, good torque, and it's also going to use minimal oil. Now, this process does require a specialized step-by-step approach, and it's important to understand what we're trying to do here. We don't need to baby the engine and nurse it along for thousands of miles. In fact, what we actually want to do is use a little bit of cylinder pressure to our advantage. Now, the radial tension of the rings alone don't really help them to seal against the bore, and the key to getting the rings to seal against the bore or push outwards against the bore is the cylinder pressure above the piston. So when we use a light to moderate amount of load on the engine, using our throttle of course here, this helps push those rings out against the bore and helps them bed. Of course, when they are running against that fresh hone pattern though, this does create a lot of friction, and in turn this creates heat. So we don't want to apply sustained high load, otherwise we could end up with too much heat being generated. So instead what we're going to be doing is using moderate to light load. We're going to be cycling between periods of moderate to light load, and then we're going to be backing off the throttle. And when we back off the throttle, this allows the rings to release a little bit from the bore walls and reduces that friction and of course the heat being produced. And we're just going to be constantly changing between periods of light load and periods of no load. At the same time, we also want to vary our RPM, and at least initially, we're going to be using somewhere in the region of 2 to 3,000 RPM, and maybe as much as 30 to 40% throttle. After the initial bedding in process, we'd then start increasing both the RPM and the load. And this process also doesn't take anywhere near as long as most people think. With modern honing techniques and modern ring construction techniques, the bedding in process is usually completed within about the first 100 to 200 kilometers of use. Beyond that, your engine is running, and from here on in, it's all running out. So you might as well get to enjoy it and start using it how it was intended.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.